Welcome to This Week in Baltimore Eating. This is not Richard Grelick, neither is that. I'm Amanda Krotki. This is my special guest, John Hauser. He is the creator of the foodie podcast, The Rouxde Cooking School. Richard is stuck in jury duty, so good luck with that, Richard. You can join us here every Thursday at 12:30 to talk about everything food-related in Baltimore. This Week in Baltimore Eating is brought to you by Eddie's Arolin Park, where they're as obsessed with delicious food as we are. Check out their premium ice creams, including Taharka Brothers and vegan Kajoo Cream, on Roland Avenue, North Charles Street in Baltimore. Welcome, John!
Hey, how's it going?
How are you?
Good, I'm great.
So this is fun. I feel like this is kismet that Richard couldn't be here today.
I actually prefer that he's not here.
I do too.
Yeah.
I'm glad Richard's stuck in
jury duty.
I hope
he's sweating.
I hope they're showing him that one Haley Joel Osment movie that they always show in jury
duty. I hope
duty.
People are talking in the quiet room and driving him crazy.
Yeah. So this is great because we actually go back a bit,
yeah,
because Baltimore,
you're my old editor. Yeah,
yes, that's crazy. I have probably not even spoken to you since. So we worked at a little website that could it was called metromix.com, and it was an entertainment and events listing site, and John used to go out and do all kinds of really fun food features for us.
Yeah, it was my first paid writing gig.
Wow.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, we really do go back. So
on Richard's insistence that I work there.
Really?
Yeah, he's the one that got me hooked up with you, I think.
That's really?
Yeah.
Okay, so small. That's crazy. I didn't even realize that. Yeah, because I've known Richard a long time before I worked with him at mm-hmm. The Sun. So we used to like really try to push envelopes and just be counterculture-y and alternative,
yeah,
at Metromix. Pour one out. It was great. Shout out if you remember it. But so we sent you on some crazy assignments, I believe.
Yes, you sent me on an assignment to try food in strip clubs.
And how did that work out for you?
Surprisingly well. The food was really good. I was amazed.
Yeah. Lots of steaks, right?
Lots of steaks, but they were trying different stuff. They actually had accredited chefs. You know, it wasn't just some dude in the back or the, you know, like the girl who can't do it anymore. And they just put her peg leg back there.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, so I remember you did a review of, I think, Scores.
Yeah, it was like five places.
Millstream.
Well, it started because my buddy always had it.
It was a rough assignment, man.
Yeah, my buddy always had this thing. He's like, never eat a strip club. But I kind of want to. And I was like, it can't be terrible if that many people do it.
And it worked out.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah.
It was good.
Millstream had very, very good food. I'm not kidding.
Thumbs up if you remember Millstream. Yeah. And also, tell us where your favorite strip club is for a good steak dinner. Because we need to know. All right. So you have the podcast, The Rouxde Cooking School.
Yes.
Tell us what is this deal? What's happening there?
Me and my co-host, Rebecca Madriaga, talk. It's basically a food history / comedy podcast.
Sounds amazing.
So every week I come up with a topic and we go through the history of it, some crazy facts. We always try to have like a good kicker story at the end, like on the episode about peas. Mm-hmm. There was a man who had really bad lungs, but was eating peas and raw peas and inhaled one.
Ew.
And it grew on the inside of his lung. And they thought he had lung cancer, and they opened it up and it was a sprouted pea in his lung.
So when they saw the x-ray, they saw a spot on his lung.
Yeah. And they thought it was like a black star, and it wasn't. It was a sprouted pea.
I'm pretty sure I got one up my nose once. And also I don't like mashed peas.
I love mashed.
I don't like
mushy peas.
Yeah, mushy peas. I don't
mashed
not like
with
those.
Like butter and mint were good. It's extra salt.
I like a good pea salad with like some arugula and some Parmesan, mm-hmm, and lemon rind. Mm.
I still haven't gotten peas from the farmer's market. It's driving
me
crazy.
I did that once and it was delicious.
Every
not
time
this
I
year,
go,
though.
They're out.
Is it seasoned?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Every time I go, I literally was behind the lady who got the last bag a couple weeks ago, and I almost had an aneurysm.
You should have fought her.
Yeah.
You should have been like, what do you want?
Just snatch her bag and leave. Yeah.
Yeah. You could have told her the long story, maybe, but she would have dropped the bag,
right,
bag and run.
But the the podcast is fun. Rebecca doesn't know what the topic's going to be.
Oh,
so we play a little fun
her.
Game of her trying to figure it out, and then we learn about it together.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's a lot of fun.
So, like, what was last week's topic?
I did aluminum foil for grilling,
oh,
which actually it's aluminium foil. I found out that the proper pronunciation and spelling is aluminium. And the reason that it's spelled like aluminum in America is because Webster's dictionary, Webster didn't want to change it because he preferred aluminum.
Okay.
Because the guy who named it it aluminum.
Good old Al.
Right? It was allium and then aluminum. And then his friends wanted him to change it to aluminium. So they did all around the world. Except in America, because of the Webster Dictionary.
I can't make my mouth say aluminium.
I hate it, now I feel like I have to do it because that's the proper name.
Do you go to the grocery and ask for some aluminium foil?
No. But if you sit around, I was sitting around last week just in a room by myself going, aluminium.
It's aluminium. Horrible. I hate it.
It does have a nice bounciness to it.
Okay, but do you...
How was your aluminium today? You know, that kind of thing.
So do you recommend the aluminium for grilling?
Yes, it's great for grilling.
Shiny side up?
Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter at all.
The reason that it's shiny is because of the way it's processed. I know too much about aluminium.
Oh my God, you really do.
No, I do. We do deep dives into things. Yeah.
All right, you guys have to watch or listen to the
And I do have to say, it's not for children, so don't listen with we have very, very
that's
bad
That's fine.
Mouths.
We don't like family-friendly activities
Although
here.
That's not true. I do have an episode with my son.
Oh, so, special one.
Special
was
episode.
It about like what he likes to eat?
It was about
chicken fingers.
We have a sauce called Crosby sauce. His name's Crosby that we make just for him, and it's basically talking about his sauce that we make.
Is it as secret as
no?
Dry
I give
sauce?
The I give the recipe out.
So it's what's it comparable just to?
It's soy sauce, mayonnaise, ketchup, sesame oil, fish sauce. And a couple other things.
Wow.
Just off the top of my head. Yeah, wow. It's actually pretty complicated.
It sounds like it would be good on some sushi.
It's really good on sushi.
See?
It's great with
French. All right, Crosby.
Great with French
Nailed
fries.
Nailed it.
Yeah.
Richard's here. Hey, Richard. You're not making
Boo.
Important decisions in that jury pool right now. He says he's on lunch break. So, but we're having fun without you, so. All right. I know you chimed in on the show a few weeks ago for Father's Day and mm-hmm. said you were getting taken to Crabtown, USA.
Crabtown, USA.
Yeah,
it was great.
I've never been there.
So I hadn't either. And when I went to college, my parents moved out to Glen Burnie from Baltimore.
Okay.
And I was less than a mile away from there
and
for 5
went.
Years.
Wow.
Before I moved back to Baltimore. And yeah, so you walk in and it's a crab house.
Uh-huh.
And we got crabs, and they were excellent.
Oh, yeah?
And yeah. And
what
then
size?
We got the larges.
Okay.
But they also had, like, I think on the weekends, $55 all you can eat.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And we were seeing the all you can eat, and they were good size. But we got, like, a fried platter just to get, you know, fried oysters, fried shrimp, fried fish, that kind
of
thing.
Yeah, of course.
Crab
all
balls.
The fry.
And we ate that, and it was great. Beer cold. Awesome. Happy Father's Day.
Yeah.
But on the side of the building,
uh-huh.
you go through a portal into 1984 again. They have over 100 old arcade style, you know,
oh
console
God.
Boxes.
Pac-Man.
Pac-Man
Mrs.
was there.
Pac-Man.
She was there too.
I love yeah. when she's there. She brings it to the party.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, yeah.
The bow.
Centipede.
Yes.
Asteroids.
All of them.
Galaxy.
My son
Dick
was obsessed
Doug.
With
I could have spent the whole day
Q-Bert,
there.
Yeah.
Q-Bert.
The original Super Mario Brothers game, they had the first Mario Brothers game, which came out before that. Yeah, I was
that
in
place
heaven.
Is heaven.
Yeah,
it is.
We were there for like just in the arcade for almost 3 hours.
I would have
because you
that.
Just walk around
do
drinking
you just
beer
need
and
coins or do you have
yeah,
to get
takes
yeah.
quarters? They have one of those old change machines.
Uh-huh.
And surprisingly, like a quarter a game. Like they didn't
Whoa.
Jack up any of the prices.
Oh my God.
They also have pinball machines.
Do they have skee ball?
No.
I'm a big skee ball fan.
So am I. I was just playing two nights ago.
Johnny
Rads. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. I have to do a commercial.
Sure.
If you just got here, you're watching This Week in Baltimore Eating, which is brought to you by Eddie's Roland Park. Craving a restaurant quality burger at home? Eddie's grinds their beef fresh daily from home, whole cuts of free and chuck, round and sirloin. Be sure to comment, like, share, and follow at hashtag JMoreEating. We are here with John Hauser, who has created the foodie podcast The Rouxde Cooking School. Rouxde is spelled Rouxde. Where else have you eaten lately?
Well, at Johnny Rad's, I had their vegan chicken cheesesteak.
Oh my God.
It was really good.
Was it?
Yeah. I wasn't expecting much.
That's a lot
we're
of
trying
vegan.
To, we're trying to do a thing where we're eating vegetarian from Monday to Thursday.
Okay.
And then it just becomes meat-a-palooza on the weekends.
Yes.
Like, yesterday I took the day off and just grilled a bunch of chickens and stuff, but, So we're just trying to stick to it. And we met up with some friends. And yeah, it was the vegan chicken cheesesteak was really good.
Okay.
Yeah, it was really like the fake cheese plastic sauce. It was really good. It was spicy and yeah.
All right, vegans, you heard it here first. Yeah. Go to Johnny Rats. So I should add this since Richard's here sort of with us. He went to Topside, which is the restaurant at the Hotel Revival in Mount Vernon. Richard, if you're still here, you can join in. But I know he said there was a good burger. Hmm. So one thing I was talking to him about, my birthday's this weekend. I'm not going to be in town, but I'm going to come back and I'm going to need a birthday dinner. And if anyone's watching, tell me where to go. So I always want to go somewhere new. So I was asking him if I wanted to go to Topside for that. But he didn't think I would like it for my birthday. He thought it would be great for to go for a burger, but not for my birthday.
My birthday was a few weeks ago.
Okay, what did you do?
We went to Gunther & Company.
See, that was on my list because I went for Christmas dinner, like a nice formal Christmas dinner, and it was great. Yeah. And I thought, well, seasonal, maybe the menus all changed and I'd probably really like it. That was totally on my list.
It was excellent. Yeah. They have this drink that's like a combination of like there's moonshine in it, which normally would turn me off.
Exactly.
But there's all these other things. It tasted sort of, it was really bright green. It had a little flower on it. My wife got one first because I forget what I got. And it wasn't great.
I had a really good drink there. But it was over like Christmas,
almost like pickle juice.
Oh, interesting.
But it was that kind of weird refreshing, like, you know, they had like a shrub or something in it,
yeah,
you know, which
course.
Is like a vinegar
I like
thing.
A shrub.
Right.
I like a grapefruit shrub.
And then the food was amazing.
Yeah.
We got this like shrimp and grits deal, and it was probably the best shrimp and grits I've had in a few years.
And you've had it, I'm sure, at Charleston.
Yeah, I've had it around, and it was really good. And for people with children, my son got a steak, which they have on the kids menu, and it was like $9, and it was perfectly cooked. They actually asked him how he wanted it, you know. And,
oh my god, that's
because normally with kids
they just
overcook everything.
Whatever.
Here's your steak. Yeah. So, but yeah, they were very attentive, and I really enjoy that place.
That's good because you can keep him out of the strip clubs. He won't go there for a steak.
Not until he's 10.
He can go to Gunther. Yeah. That is funny. I was totally considering Gunther & Company. One of my go-tos is Vito in Cockeysville. Mm-hmm. I like their Italian. So yeah. I was sort of leaning toward that, but I like the idea.
Plus, Gunther & Company is just really
it's
open.
Pretty.
They have that living wall.
I love the plant wall. I know. So if anyone else has any suggestions, but I like what John's telling me. So tell me if you have any other thoughts. I also was thinking recently about the Bite of Baltimore food tours. Have you ever taken one of those?
No.
So they do them. They do them in like Fells Point, Mount Vernon, around. It's kind of a little pricey. It's a walking tour.
Okay.
And I guess you go to several stops. But I was thinking about trying one.
So what is it?
It's a food tour company.
They just take you around and let you...
I think they just take you around and you maybe have like a nibble at each place, possibly.
That's weird.
I know. I want to go back to what you just said about pickle juice.
Right.
Glenn, I think, told me or mentioned somewhere that he had a pickle juice... slushy. But it was real, right? It's a thing. So Sonic has pickle juice slushies.
Yeah, it was like a big deal. A lot of people were very disappointed by them. Apparently, it's not pickly enough.
I think you said you liked it.
It's good.
It was
good.
Interesting, though.
Yeah, no.
I don't know that
pickle juice is like a thing now. Like,
I know.
You can buy like popsicles.
Huh.
Yeah, you can buy just jars of pickle juice now.
It would be super easy to make a pickle juice popsicle.
You know what's great with pickle juice?
No.
Brine your chicken.
Oh.
Brine chicken breast in
that
it.
That is a good one.
Then flour it and It's basically that's the secret to Chick-fil-A, is that they brine their chicken. Yeah, I think so.
Really?
Yeah.
You just gave everyone the secret to Chick-fil-A?
Yeah, they're homophobic. I don't need to do that.
Yeah, whatever. We don't care about them.
Let's steal their secrets.
Tell them all. All right, so real fast, I'm going to run down these because Richard was going to and he's not here. So restaurant news. Banff Cafe is closing later this month in Station North. That's another Station North.
And that was like
closing.
A nerd haven, too.
It's a comic book themed spot. Mm-hmm. So there's that. New American Diner closed on Sunday. That's on Utah Street.
Yeah.
A new Caribbean place named Montego Bar and Grill opened where Caribbean Paradise was.
Okay.
So that's cool. That's on Charles Street. You like jerk chicken?
I do.
Yeah, I'm not a big jerk chicken person.
Yeah.
So I don't really get into a lot of jerk. I know lots of jerks, though.
I normally don't order it out. I'd like to make it.
Yeah.
Because then I can control the spiciness of it.
Exactly.
Because a lot of it just blows your face
off.
Too
much. Yeah. You got to be able to taste something when
you're
done. Exactly. All right. So before we go, how can people find your podcast?
You can find us at Rouxde Podcast, RouxdePodcast, on Twitter and on Instagram. We have a Facebook group that is it's growing. Yeah. We got about 1,000 people now. Everyone's sharing recipes, asking recommendations, sharing their dinners. We a lot of stupid memes.
Okay.
So add yourself to that. And
because like memes.
Before we record the podcast, we do like a 30-minute pre-show where we talk to the people on the Facebook page. We always have a topic. So I got to come up with a topic tonight. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's like, what do you like to do for birthday? So there it is. Figure out a topic.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. Where do you like to go for your birthday? So tonight we'll sit there and talk to Facebook for about 30 minutes and Instagram and, you know, do that out. And then we record the program and it comes out every Friday.
Great. Awesome. So make sure you listen to that. I will put all that information in the comments field.
Great.
And you should come back.
I would love
to hang out with Richard because I know.
By the way, Richard's been on the podcast, so if you want to listen to Richard wax nostalgically about being a food writer in Baltimore,
awesome. Okay, so definitely come back and join us.
Thank you
to John Hauser. He is the creator of Foodie Podcast, The Rouxde Cooking School. You can tune in every Thursday at 12:30 for This Week in Baltimore Eating, which has been brought to you by Eddie's of Roland Park. Visit Eddie's for fresh Gundaloo juices, Brew Doctor Kombucha, Michelle's granola, and more local flavors you know and love. Visit eddiesandrolandpark.com. Let us know what is on your mind and what new spots you've discovered lately. Have a great weekend.